Fear not, or actually do fear, the Brighton Horror Fest is back for the third year in a row, bolder and scarier than ever. I spoke with a spooky organiser to find out more.
Constantly growing, evolving, spreading, taking over the town and our lives.
Our lives,
which
yes.
is wonderful.
I mean, it took our lives first, Horror Fest, yeah. Really. Yeah. We were the first victims.
And now it's finding fresh souls. All so time. Everyone wins.
Where did the idea came from?
A love of horror.
Yeah.
And absolutely. A genuine surprise that there wasn't already something like this in Brighton.
Yeah.
Because it feels like the right place for it. But one of the beautiful things about horror, I always say, is that there's something in it for everyone. So we've got something for everyone,
yeah, absolutely.
I think.
Yeah, we've got kids' shows, we've got solo performances. There has been spoken word, storytelling, magic, cabaret, burlesque, you name it, it's all been featured. It's a proper festival.
Yeah. I've been a little bit obsessed with since I was traumatised by a bad horror film as a very small child, and something inside me changed and mutated. And after I got over the terror, I found a strong love for horror. What about you?
I think probably just like from a very young age being exposed to like ghost stories and all the like, and then that just continuing. And you know, as you can tell from the accent, you know, being up north and it's a bit darker and colder. Halloween in Scotland's always been a really big thing with people going guising and that sort of thing. And so yeah, it's sort of embedded in our culture.
Halfway through the Horror Fest, what have we got left to come? We've got plays, we've got seances, we've got lectures.
We've got short films from local creatives.
Absolutely.
Which is fantastic. Yep. We've got kids shows still to happen this week.
Yes, that's still to come.
As well, so that's great. So stuff from the afternoons all the way through to the wee hours of the night.
We haven't taken the Horror Festival to the point that it actually reaches Halloween, because people are doing other things for Halloween. They've got their own
exactly.
plans.
Exactly, they've got parties, they've got all that stuff, they've got right. stuff they want to do with their families. So we've always arranged that Horror Festival runs for a spooky 13 days up to Halloween, and then lets everybody get on with whatever crazy they want to get on with in the city.
Yeah, it's a sort of Halloween advent calendar. You can do all the horror leading up to the big event.
Exactly, and, open and another door, scream, and then wait for tomorrow.
Absolutely,
So we'll be finishing up on Sunday. Which is the 28th.
You can find all of it at brightonhorrorfest.com. You just need to go along to there and you can see all the shows that we've got coming up this week. You can buy your tickets directly through.
Dead easy.
So easy.
Dead easy.
Well, better to be dead easy than easily dead.
This is William Ranieri for Latest TV News.